Hello friends, hope all of you are doing great. So today we are trying to record a video of the Volkswagen Taigun infotainment system. Let's see what are the possible options here. So right now it is connected to the Apple CarPlay. Okay, so now there are two kind of options available right now because it is connected to Apple CarPlay. So Apple CarPlay options are there and basic stock options which are provided by Volkswagen infotainment system, those are also there. So let's go at the home. So this is the home. Here you can see that Apple CarPlay music is playing. You can make a phone call from here. You can try to connect with the radio. Right, this way you can select whatever you want. Okay, and then you can go with the navigation. So when you click the navigation, it will take you to the default Sygic app. Okay, let's turn off the radio. Okay, and another possible, and here you can connect the new phone if you want. So right now two phones are connected, sorry, three. If you want to add more devices, you can add. It is connected through Android Auto, this Apple CarPlay, and this is also Apple CarPlay. Okay, and if you scroll this side, it shows the driving data, vehicle status, notifications. If you click on it, it gives you a... Okay, so right now ignition is not turned on. Let us try to turn on the ignition. See. So you can see this is the current data, which is it's showing that it's 18.7 consumption. It is showing mileage. Basically, this is the trip length and the average speed and the time which we take to drive this one. So these are the basic things. You can see a few things like driving data, since refuel, and then you can see long term data also. So long term consumption is 13.4 kmph. It's don't go on these numbers. It's a very new car, and these days we are just trying to drive it rough, sometimes it's smooth. So, and when we got the car, it was 6 something kilometer per liter. So this is significantly improving. Here you can see these two apps, Gaana and Sygic, and you can try to find more apps on here. So you can search the apps you can search apps you want here. So right now, first thing, it is not connected with Wi-Fi, so we'll connect and then try to show. Although we didn't find any apps available, maybe we didn't check correctly. Okay, so you can update those apps and you can change the settings and other stuff, right? So this is the basic stock UI provided by the Volkswagen. Now I'll take you to the Apple Music here. This is the song. If you click here, it will show you the apps which you can, you know, control from here. You can, it's a split view, you can see the map and other things here. If you change it this way, so Siri is also available. If you want to search something, you can kick in, right? So this is another thing, and here you can, you know, go and change the songs. You can browse something, you can go into the Apple Radio library. Okay, so everything you can access from here. So when you change something on your phone which is connected through Apple Play, it reflects here and vice versa. So they are in sync, kind of. If you want to call, so you can use keypad, or you can go to the contacts or the recent, and then you can do that part. If you want to use Apple Map or any other map, if you are using that icon, will come here. Okay, so you can search, or you can type whatever you want. You can use Siri also for this. So right now ignition is on. If I click here and ignition, this traction control will be on and it will show on the MID also. See here. And if I turn it off, see, you can do this thing. Okay. So this is the thing. Another thing, if you see in the infotainment system, these are the settings where, you know, I can turn off the screen this way and just tap on it and it will come up. It's not coming up. Okay. You need to tap a bit strongly or hard. Okay. And then you can change the audio, you can choose the balancer, fader, right? So, and you can do this thing. So it's pretty cool. And if I go back, you can control the instrument cluster lights. Okay. Brightness will go, we'll show you. So see, focus on the lights here. Once I increase it, brightness will increase. If I reduce it, brightness will go down. Right, so you can control the MID. So now there is another option. If you want to control, if you see here is a white ambient light, it will go off, it will come up. If you want to increase the brightness of this ambient light, you can do it. Okay. And there are coming home lights and leaving home lights, convenience indication, all these things are there. And if I go into the media, you can select your audio volume and other stuff, right? You can control the Bluetooth settings and other devices. Okay. And then if you go into the apps, you can see what are the apps installed and other stuff. So pretty basic stuff is there. Okay. So now I'll take you the brightness of the infotainment system itself, so you can control it. Okay, there is a valet mode, so once you turn it on, you need to put a pin here. It will be active, blocking all functions till you enter your pin code. Now you can select the profiles also. You can, you know, change your name here if you want. Change the, this is the valet profile, this is the main profile. Okay, you can change the security pin, you can delete the pin code, all these basic stuff, right? And audio we have already seen. If you want to connect a device, right? You want to, if you want to turn on the Wi-Fi, let's turn it on. Okay, so the device which we are, you know, connected with, so that will be disconnected if I turn on the Wi-Fi. So I'm not doing it now. Pause the music or mute the music, you can just click on it. So it do not pause, but it mutes, I think. And then again it will play. And this is when you want to go to the music, that which device is playing the music. You can see it here also. Apple CarPlay is connected right now. Radio, if you want to do, you can do that. Okay, this will take you to the Apple one. So we have already seen these options. These are the infotainment system control. I mean, you can increase the volume, change the song, all that kind of stuff, or, you know, mute it or pause it. So all that stuff is there. And one more thing, if your phone or any device is connected to it and it has a internet connection, then this infotainment system can also connect with the Wi-Fi of that. And let me show you that how this offline Sygic map looks like, something like this. And you can, you know, search anything you want here. And this is an offline map. Once you update it, it works offline. And you can update it again. So whenever you connect your phone or any device which is having a Wi-Fi, so it can be updated. Our car was parked very near to our Wi-Fi router, so we connected it directly from there and updated it. So that is also an option. If you see here, yeah, this is the way you can turn on and turn off the Wi-Fi. Right, let me show you.
hotspot.
Okay. So see, it is showing the number of hotspots to which hotspot you want to connect. So that is also one of the options. So right now we do not want to connect with anyone. So once it will be connected, this icon will be like kind of connected, not the crossed one. Okay, so Android Auto options are available here. You can see maps, YouTube music, podcast, Google search using voice, you can do that. So these are the pretty basic options. You can customize the look and feel, right? So your customizer opens on phone and then you can change it. See here, and you can do whatever you want. So it will just sync. So controls are on phone. Okay. So I guess that's it from our side on the infotainment part now. It's working smoothly and it's very easy to use. No need to use it very harshly or something like that. It's very smooth, very good. And so far we haven't found any glitch in it. Okay, there was one problem when we got the car. We were trying to update the... these maps, but they were not working. So what we did, we reset the infotainment system. Okay, and how to do that part?
System.
Here you go, system. And then system reset, we did it, and it worked for us. Screen off. If you want to screen to be auto off, you can do that. If you want to do something related to brightness, skins are there. Okay, touch a screen sound if you want to turn on, turn off. So all these options are there. That's it from our side on the infotainment system. Stay connected, and very soon we are going to get the interior mat flooring and seat covers done. So we will come back with a very good video. Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. Have a great day.